जय हिंद लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इट गिव्स मी ए ग्रेट प्लेजर टू एक्सटेंड ए वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू ईच वन ऑफ यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग दिस वीडियो प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन कॉकपिट ऑटोमेशन। कॉकपिट ऑटोमेशन हैज बीन ए मेजर बून फॉर द पायलट्स एंड विद द टेक्नोलॉजी डेवलपिंग वेरी फास्ट, फर्दर एनहेंसमेंट इन कॉकपिट ऑटोमेशन can be expected. Unfortunately, the cockpit automation have been a contributory factor in a number of major accidents, including two high profile crashes overseas involving Boeing 737 MAX in 2018 and then 2019. Based on studies carried out, it has been found that most of the pilots often lack adequate understanding of automated systems. Hence, this video has been specially prepared to refresh and enhance the knowledge of the pilots so that they have a better understanding of the cockpit automation and can fly safely and efficiently without any problems. Let's now have a look at the generations of automation. There are three generations of automation systems. First generation, autopilot flight director, features a partial integration of the autopilot flight director and auto throttle modes, which offers selected autopilot flight director modes and lateral navigation only. The second generation features complete integration of autopilot flight director and auto throttle modes and offers selected modes as well as lateral navigation and vertical navigation. The third generation features full regime, lateral navigation and vertical navigation. Now we'll discuss the operating philosophy. The flight management system or selected guidance can be used in succession or in combination, that is FMS lateral guidance together with selected vertical guidance as best suited for the flight phase and prevailing conditions. Operations of the automatic flight systems must be monitored at all times by cross-checking the status of autopilot flight director and auto throttle modes armed and selected on the flight management annunciator. Observing the result of any target entry on the automatic flight system control panel on the related data as displayed on the primary flight display or the navigation display. Supervising the resulting autopilot flight director guidance and auto throttle operation on the primary flight display and navigation display, that is attitude, airspeed, airspeed trend, altitude, vertical speed, heading, etc. The pilot flying always retains the authority and the capability to use the most appropriate guidance and level of automation for the task. This includes reverting from FMS guidance to selected guidance, that is more direct level of automation. Selecting a more appropriate lateral mode or vertical mode. Reverting to hand flying, that is with or without flight director, with or without auto throttle for direct control of the aircraft trajectory and thrust. If doubt exists about the aircraft's flight path or airspeed control, no attempt should be made to reprogram the automated systems. Selected guidance or hand flying with raw data should be used until time and conditions permit reprogramming the autopilot flight director or flight management system. If the aircraft does not follow the intended flight path, pilot should check the autopilot engagement status. If engaged, the autopilot must be disconnected using the auto disconnect switch to revert to hand flying with flight director guidance or with reference to raw data. When hand flying, the flight director command should be followed. Otherwise, the flight director command bars should be cleared from the primary flight display. If the auto throttle does not function as desired, the auto throttle must be disconnected using the auto throttle disconnect switch to revert to manual thrust control. Autopilot systems and auto throttle systems must not be overridden manually except under conditions set forth in the aircraft operating manual or quick reference handbook. Now we will discuss various factors and errors committed by pilots. First one is inadvertent arming of a mode or selection of an incorrect mode. Secondly, failure to verify the arm mode or selected mode by reference to the flight management annunciator. Entering an incorrect target, that is altitude, airspeed, heading on the automatic flight system control panel, and failure to confirm the entered target on the primary flight display and or navigation display. Changing the automatic flight system control panel altitude target to any altitude below the final approach intercept altitude during approach. Inserting an incorrect waypoint. Arming the LNAV mode with an incorrect active waypoint, that is with an incorrect to waypoint. Preoccupation with flight management system programming during a critical flight phase with consequent loss of situational awareness. Inadequate understanding of modes changes, that is mode confusion and automation surprises. Inadequate task sharing and or inadequate crew resource management, preventing the pilot flying from monitoring the flight path and airspeed, that is both pilots being engaged in the management automation or in the troubleshooting of an unanticipated or abnormal condition. Engaging the autopilot or disengaging the autopilot when the aircraft is in an out of trim condition. Now we'll discuss automation dependency. Now, automation dependency has commonly been described as a situation in which pilots who routinely fly aircraft with automated systems are only fully confident in their ability to control the trajectory of their aircraft when using the full functionality of such systems. Such a lack of confidence usually stems from a combination of inadequate knowledge of the automated systems themselves, unless all are employed, and a lack of manual flying and aircraft management competence. I will discuss various recommendations for optimum utilization of automated cockpit systems. Operators must ensure that the pilots understand the functionality of automated system and its partial as well as full use. It's very important. The operators should ensure that pilots are able to understand the importance of monitoring the expected function of automation so that in the event their incorrect inputs or malfunction have unexpected consequences, timely corrective action can be taken. It also must be ensured that the pilots can identify and use the appropriate level of automation for the task in hand. In order to reduce the workload during the cruise phase, highest levels of automation using flight management computer for navigation and flight path control must be used by the pilots. Pilots should not use flight management computer to control the flight path in the terminal area to cope with rapid changes to the required flight path, since it may lead to saturation of the crew with tasks and loss of situational awareness. The autopilot flight director systems must be disengaged promptly, and manual handling should be resorted to recover the situation in the event of undesired deviations or excursions from the required flight path. The auto throttle must be seen as part of the overall automation system. Pilots must be able to competently fly the aircraft with or without it engaged, just as they would be expected to be able to fly the aircraft with or without the autopilot. It is the duty and responsibility of the operators and director of operations to enhance the standards of basic recurrent training and testing practices with regard to automation management, multi-crew cooperation concept, airmanship, manual flying skills of pilots, and the development of automation policies specific to aircraft types and variants to account for differences regarding automation and flight path management. During normal line operations, the autopilot and auto throttle should be engaged throughout the flight, including the descent and approach, especially in marginal weather or when operating into an unfamiliar airport. The pilot should be aware and understand system operation, the results of any action, modes being armed or selected, and seek concurrence of other flight crew members. After performing the action on the automated flight system control panel or on the flight management system central display unit, the pilot should cross-check armed modes, selected modes, and target entries on the flight management annunciator, primary flight display, navigation display, and flight management system central display unit. Before engaging the autopilot, the pilots must ensure that the modes selected for flight director guidance, as shown by the flight management annunciator, are the correct modes for the intended flight phase, and the flight director command bars do not show large flight path correction commands. If large corrections are commanded, hand fly the aircraft to center the flight director command bars. Engaging the autopilot while large flight path corrections are required may result in overshooting the intended target. Before taking any action on the automated flight system control panel, pilots must check that the knob or the push button is the correct one for the desired function. After each action on the automated flight system control panel, verify the result of the action by reference to the flight management annunciator for mode arming or mode selection and to other primary flight display public navigation display data for entered targets or by reference to the flight path and airspeed. Pilots must monitor the flight management annunciator and call all mode changes in accordance with standard operating procedures. When changing the altitude entered on the automated flight system control panel, pilots should cross-check the selected altitude readout on the primary flight display. During descent, pilot must check whether the entered altitude is below the minimum en route altitude or minimum safe altitude. If the entered altitude is below the MEA or MSA, pilots must obtain altitude confirmation from ATC. During final approach, pilots must set the go-around altitude on the automated flight system control panel altitude window. The minimum descent altitude oblique height or decision altitude oblique height should not be set in the window. Pilot must prepare the FMS for arrival before beginning the descent. An expected alternative arrival routing and or runway can be prepared on the second flight plan. If a routing change occurs that is direct to waypoint, cross check the new to waypoint before selecting the direct to mode by making sure that the intended direct to waypoint is not already behind the aircraft. Before arming the LNAV mode, pilots must ensure that the correct active waypoint, that is the to waypoint, is displayed on the flight management system central display unit and navigation display as applicable. If the displayed to waypoint is not correct, the desired to waypoint can be restored by either deleting an intermediate waypoint or performing a direct to the desired waypoint and then monitoring the interception of the lateral flight path. If a late routing change or runway change occurs, reversion to selected modes and raw data is recommended. Reprogramming the flight management system during a critical flight phase, that is in terminal area, on approach or go around is not recommended except to activate the second flight plan if needed. Primary tasks in order of priority should be lateral flight path control and vertical flight path control, altitude awareness and traffic awareness, and ATC communications. No attempt should be made to analyze or to correct an anomaly by reprogramming the automated flight system or the flight management system until the desired flight path and airspeed are restored. If clear to leave a holding pattern on a radar vector, the holding exit prompt should be pressed or the holding pattern otherwise deleted to allow the correct sequencing of the flight management system, flight path, flight plan. On a radar vector, when intercepting the final approach course in a selected mode, that is heading, localizer capture, etc., the flight crew should ensure that the flight management system flight plan is sequencing normally by checking that the two waypoint on the flight management system central display unit and the navigation display as applicable is correct, so that the LNAV mode can be reselected for a go around. If the flight management system flight plan does not sequence correctly, the correct sequencing can be restored by either by deleting an intermediate waypoint or performing a direct waypoint ahead in the approach. Otherwise, the LNAV mode should not be used for the remainder of the approach or for a go around. Anytime the aircraft does not follow the desired flight path and or airspeed, do not hesitate to revert to a lower, more direct level of automation. For example, revert from flight management system to selected modes. Disengage the autopilot and follow flight director guidance. Disengage the flight director, select the flight path vector as available, and fly raw data or fly visually if in visual meteorological conditions. And or disengage the auto throttle and control the thrust manually. Ladies and gentlemen, to conclude, automated flight control system have largely been viewed as having a positive effect on safety, and accident rates have improved considerably over the past two decades. However, the increasing complexity of automated flight systems has sometimes caused confusion and uncertainty, contributing to improper pilot actions during critical phases of flight and in some cases leading pilots to unintentionally place an aircraft in an unsafe condition. Number of accidents have also involved either failure of automated systems or pilot confusion or the operation of automated features resulting in improper interaction with these systems. Research has shown that piloting skills associated with marooning aircraft using manual control decline as a consequence of flying highly automated aircraft. Proper use of automated systems reduces workload and increases the time and resources available to the flight crew for responding to any unanticipated change or abnormal or emergency condition. The automated flight system or the flight management system is a valuable aid during a go-around or missed approach. Using the automated flight system also enables the flight crew to give more attention to air traffic control communication and to other aircraft particularly in congested terminal areas. The automated flight system / flight management system also is a valuable aid during a go-round or missed approach. The extremely high reliability rate of automated systems has created a safer, more efficient operating environment. Reduced weather minima and improved flight path control allows for higher traffic volume and on-time operations. For pilots, proper automation management results in a reduced workload and increased situational awareness. Additionally, aircraft maintainers benefit from faster, more accurate diagnosing the aircraft malfunction and inoperative equipment. It is imperative that the pilots are properly trained on these automated systems prior to conducting line operations. In the operational environment, it is imperative that pilots not only have appropriate knowledge, but also a level of trust in their aircraft systems to operate safely. In order to create an efficient and effective training program, it is important to understand how pilots perceive their role on the modern flight deck and how they prefer to learn the functionality of automated aircraft systems, ranging from autoflight modes to an aircraft's flight management system. Automation surprise, that is, breakdowns in the interaction between human operators and automated systems, can degrade the situational awareness of the pilot and, in some cases, the safety of the flight. Perception plays a role because it can display vulnerabilities to certain types of errors on the flight deck. Important factors include level of trust in automation, system knowledge, and how system functionality are taught. Over-reliance on automated system can lead to surprise and loss of situational awareness, leading to serious incident / accidents. The operators must train and brief the pilots to never be complacent and use the automated systems intelligently, for which they should have good knowledge related to these systems. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Cockpit automation has gone a long way in relieving the pilots of the fatigue of flying and has definitely enhanced safety of operations. However, it must be clearly understood by the operators that the pilots acquire and update their knowledge about the cockpit automation, lest the cockpit automation, which was introduced for the benefit of pilots, lead to an accident or incident due to lack of knowledge on the part of pilots. Hope you find this video useful. Wishing you all a very happy and safe flying and many happy landings. Jai Hind.